I'm Joel Baird, the general manager of Missoula Community Access Television, inviting you to this first edition of Missoula Live. For what year is it?
Oh my gosh, I can't even think. Five?
I think it's our fifth year.
Fifth year?
Is Kim Anderson, my co-host. He is an MCAP board member.
Yes, and I'm the director of programs and grants at Humanities Montana. So happy to be back for year five.
And so far, you say Humanities Montana is busy, but no major announcements.
I think we have such a full show. I think that I can talk about stuff in a few weeks. Yes.
Yes. And the only thing, we have such a full show, dear viewer, I would mention to you that MCAT has reinstated our Saturday animation drop-in
for the
school year.
It seems like it just paused for the summer.
Right? It's a seething, screaming deal. It's 1 to 5 every Saturday, and Scott and is leading the charge again. The animation drop-in teaches kids computer skills, storytelling, teamwork, and so on. It's 4 hours for a $10 fee. And do you need anything, Scott? You need Legos or? They could use a little more Legos. There had been a loan.
There's a Lego shortage.
There was like a private loan that was rescinded, but after a very gracious period. So right now, they could use.
I should go down in my basement and check, because I believe I have Legos down there.
Go in your basement and check. We could use a few more.
My son is almost 30, so I think I could safely give them away now.
We better get right on to it,
yes.
Right? So what is going on? Our first guest is Sienna Solberg. Welcome.
Hi.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for being our first guest of the season.
Right. Your organization is pretty exciting. It is Spark Arts Ignite Learning. Tell people about it.
Yeah. So we are an initiative from the Kennedy Center to bring more arts into MCPS, or Missoula County Public Schools. So we do that three different ways. Arts for art's sake, we advocate for arts positions, arts specialists in the schools, and just more art, to learn art.
Yay.
And then we also have arts enhancement opportunities for every grade level from kindergarten through eighth grade. So this week, actually, for National Arts and Education Week, our second graders are going to the Missoula Children's Theater to see Androcles and the Lion.
Excellent.
So every grade level gets an opportunity. So fifth grade goes to Missoula Art Museum.
Yeah, they've had the fifth grade art experience for decades now.
And and they have fourth grade goes to symphony. So every grade level is getting exposed to an art enhancement opportunity. And then we also have arts integration. So we have teaching artists or artists, local artists, going into the schools to teach the curriculum or content area through an art form. So they might be learning the water cycle through dance, or learning weather patterns through photography of clouds.
Sounds cool. Like time lapse came to mind.
Yeah.
You know, for the weather.
Yeah, yeah, it's really fun. So those are kind of what we do.
And you've got a bunch of events.
Yeah.
There's a very attractive card,
yes,
dear viewer, that is announcing this Arts and Education Week.
Yeah.
Now, some things may have passed, like yesterday, Sunday Streets.
Yeah, we were at Sunday Streets.
Yeah, I saw you guys.
Huge.
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah.
And then on September 11th is the event at Cafe Dolce.
Yeah.
And that starts at 5.
Yep.
And what are they doing for the Arts and Education Week?
Yeah, so we just have such a supportive community. So I was able to reach out to our community and kind of get involved in what they already do. So for example, Sunday Streets, we were there doing an art activity. And then tomorrow is Cafe Dolce, where they're giving 10% of the sales from 5 o'clock to 9 o'clock to Spark.
Oh, wonderful.
And then next Monday, the Thomas Marr Bar is doing something similar. So from 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock, they're giving 20% to Spark.
They're giving 20%.
20%.
Yeah. So it's exciting. Yeah, and so nice that these these businesses are helping us out, so.
And you've got an event with Zach, or you got a plug for their Monster Project opening.
Yeah.
And that's really fascinating. Can you tell people about that partnership? Not just Zach, but how Zach includes kids with adults for the Monster Project.
I know, it's such a cool idea. So Spark and Zach collaborate for the Monster Project. So we're kind of on the kid end. Artists go into the classrooms and kindergartners make a monster. They draw a monster and they kind of give a narrative about this monster. And then local artists, which Zach recruits, come in and make their representation of the monster. So I'm actually going to hang that show tonight.
Wonderful.
And,
my gosh.
I'm so excited to see all the monsters.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so then on Friday, there's the opening from 3:30 to 8 o'clock at Zootown Arts Community Center.
And that's in their current and old location.
Yes.
And I think it's going to be one of the final events going on there. So
wow,
it'll be
it's really exciting.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah.
It's so fun.
And you do have a website listed here, sparkartslearning.org.
Yeah.
And has a /donate.
Yeah. Yeah. So we, I think something that people may have a misconception about is because we're a Kennedy Center initiative.
Right.
Some people think maybe we get funding through the Kennedy Center,
right.
And that's not true. We get a lot of support from the Kennedy Center, but they've never written us a big check. They're trying to help us be sustainable within our own community. So, we love donations.
Right.
Absolutely. No, yeah. The Kennedy Center brings a ton of prestige in it.
Oh, yeah.
You're one of just a very few.
Yeah.
Missoula is one site of just a handful.
Yeah,
right,
I think there are maybe up to 27 now communities.
So, but the funding has to be local, and we have to support it. So
yeah.
These are all
yeah.
great events.
Yeah.
Yeah, they really are. Santa, thanks so much for coming and for working on Spark.
Yeah.
Because it sparks up some kids' lives.
Like, oh, my gosh.
Like, I can look back on a few field trips. They were magical to me
mm-hmm.
when
oh, yeah.
I was young.
I was one
I
of those kids.
I remember them now.
I would have never gotten through school without
yeah,
the arts.
Right. Without
right.
the arts.
Yeah,
too.
Exactly.
So, thank you.
Well, thanks so much for having me.
Yeah, you know
go out there
that.
And enjoy all the events. Have a glass of wine or a dinner at Cafe Dolce or the Thomas Mar Bar.
Yeah.
That's right.
And support Spark.
Spark.
Thanks
and
so
we
much.
Will be right back, dear viewer. Scott's got some new PSAs
well,
to show
good.
You. And we'll bring on our next guest right after this.
You can't sit here.
Don't add her to the chain.
It was just a joke.
We're not friends.
Why are you talking to me?
You started it.
She's so gross.
Lame.
Loser.
Weirdo.
I've said and done things before that I'm not proud of.
Just as I've been hurt by others.
The thing is, this is not who I am. And it's definitely not who I want to be.
I don't want to be cruel.
I don't want to spread gossip.
I don't want to be a body shamer.
I don't want to exclude anyone.
I don't want to make anyone feel lonely.
Left out.
Hurt.
We have the power to be more.
We can create a kinder world.
It's not that hard.
We just need to stop.
Take a moment.
And consider others before we speak.
And before we act.
Be more.
Be more.
Be more.
We're back. I just said we better get going.
Reading as fast as we can.
Right?
Yeah.
Sophia Bay is here representing Soft Landing, Missoula. Welcome and thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you for having me, yeah.
Yeah, you know it. So what we understand is what is coming up September 14th is Missoula's second annual Welcoming Week.
Yes.
And can you explain a little bit about that and Soft Landing?
Yes. So Welcoming Week is an annual series of events that's put on nationwide that brings together refugees and immigrants and native-born residents to celebrate the benefits of welcoming everybody. And Soft Landing is a nonprofit organization that helps Missoula to become an informed and welcoming community that can support refugees to integrate and thrive here in town.
Right.
Yeah.
And we were just talking before the PSA ended, and you're in your third year, is that
correct?
We are.
September marks, actually September 7th was our third year anniversary, so we are just celebrating 3 years. As Soft Landing in 2 years thanks to the IRC of resettling refugees here in Missoula.
And the IRC stands for the International Rescue Committee.
Yes, it does.
Which is an incredibly noble organization.
Yeah, right. Incredible.
And anyone paying attention to the news knows that there's a lot of tumult in the world.
Yeah.
And is generating an enormous number of refugees.
It is, yeah. Yeah, and the International Rescue Committee is the resettlement organization that actually brings the refugees here, and then we help long-term to integrate and thrive.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
What are some of the events going on for the Welcome Week?
Yes, so we have 8 events over the week.
We have a cheat sheet.
Yes, we do. There's a lot.
But the kickoff, that's cool.
Yeah,
Imagination Brewery.
Great.
Yeah. They rent such good partners.
They're incredible. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we have the kickoff event this Friday at 5:30, and they're actually brewing us a special beer.
Oh, my goodness.
I know. So we're doing that. We'll have a trivia event. All of our partners for the week will come and do a little talk on, you know, what their involvement is and how we can all support each other here in Missoula. And then we'll have a global trivia game as well, so you can learn more about refugees and test your wits.
Yeah. Cool, that sounds really good.
Yeah, it'll be a lot of fun.
Sunday, it says Supper Club.
Yes.
At the top hat, pre-sale ticketed event.
It is. So Sunday is, like you said, the Supper Club, which is a taste of the Middle East.
Yeah.
So we have 4 refugee chefs cooking for the evening. And it's every month we do a Supper Club, so this is kind of a big one for us. And it's at a new venue, the Top Hat, who are incredible people,
great.
And it'll be a really delicious meal.
I've been reading about this. It's such a great way to learn about another culture through food. And it's
fabulous. Ray Risho was very big on that.
Yeah, Ray did it for decades and decades.
Perugia, that takes me back.
Emmaus Road was the first one.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
On South, yeah.
Oh, so that's, anyway. I've heard about that.
Yeah, right.
By Sentinel or something.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, the tapas place.
Right.
Yes.
At the old bridge.
Silk Road.
Yeah.
But also refugee chefs, so people from the countries will be cooking the cuisine
as authentic as you can get.
Exactly.
Really?
So this one's going to be from refugee chefs from Iraq and Syria.
Wow.
And it'll be a 3-course family-style meal, and they get to share a little bit of their culture with Missoula.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
It is really great. Well, that leaves 6 more events.
I know.
Do you want to say them, or should we refer people to a website?
Yeah, we have them all on our Facebook page, and you can also visit softlandingmissoula.org, where we'll have the entire series of events, but we have a coffee ceremony, which is a traditional Eritrean event, and that's going to be fun. We did that last year as well. We have a soccer match between Congo and Eritrea.
Oh, really?
And doing a potluck, so that'll be a bunch of fun. And then, you know, we have the International Rescue Committee putting on a advocacy day as well. So there's a ton of different events. We have a film screening and, you know, a bunch of different exciting things. So take a peek at our website, softlandingmissoula.org.
Yeah, and Soft Landing is still probably, right, accepting and training volunteers who want to help with the resettlement effort. You know, if someone can teach a computer skill, or if someone can help people navigate the streets, or if someone has a job for somebody.
Right. Absolutely.
Or language practice.
Always,
practice. You don't even need to know a foreign language.
No.
Probably the people sometimes like people that speak fast or a slang or some other challenge so they can start tuning their ear to Montana.
Yeah, we do a lot of one-on-one tutoring. We do driver's ed. We have a lot of different programs at Soft Landing, and we do in-kind donations as well. So there's plenty of opportunities for people to get involved with us. And a good way to start is just come into the events and seeing what it's all about.
There you go.
Yeah.
You guys are doing such a great job. And I have
Thank
to say, you know, I think we've all noticed that the culture of Missoula is richer. There's just more diversity and more interesting things going on. And that's thanks in large part to our new neighbors and to your helping them.
Yeah, thanks to them. They're absolutely incredible.
Yeah.
And
so resilient.
Yeah, really, really great people.
Yeah. Well, Sophia, thank you so much for taking the time.
You're going to have a busy week.
Yeah, you are.
We're going to have a very busy week, and we hope to see you guys all there.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Imagination is the kickoff, right? Yeah.
Imagination Friday the 14th at 5:30 is our kickoff. Yeah.
Great.
All right. We'll be right back with our next guest after your new PSA for Season 5, Missoula Live.
This medication isn't in its original packaging. Proper labeling is important. Without proper labeling, misuse is likely. This cabinet is a hands-on learning experience that provides tangible tips for parents on how to keep their homes and children safe, and serves as a conversation starter about medication safety.
If your office is interested in hosting our mock medicine cabinet, or you want to learn more about medication safety, please go to choicesmattermissoula.com or email at info@missoulaforum.org.
Thanks for watching.
Well, dear viewer, you just got to look at Kira Huck. She is here representing Safe Kids Missoula. She's the Safe Kids Coordinator. And the event is coming up on Sunday, September 23rd. Welcome and thank you for being on the show.
Thank you for having me.
You know it. So what is the Safe Kids event?
So this is the Safe Kids Fair. It's an annual event that we hold every year. And it's a free event for children of all ages and parents, caregivers, grandparents, anyone that has a child in their life. And it's an event where they can come out and enjoy various hands-on safety activities to learn how to be safe at home, on the road, and during play.
Well, that sounds really good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
What are some of the exercises that if, you know, parents came or grandparents or caregivers, is it fun? You know, because it looks like it's a goodly while. It starts at 9 and it's 3 hours.
Yes, noon to 3 on community. Did I write that down?
It says 9 a.m. to noon.
Oh, my bad.
Noon to 3. I'm sorry.
Don't show up at 9 a.m.
Don't show up at 9. Please. Noon to 3 p.m. I think I've just been doing all sorts of things. Noon to 3 p.m. on Community Medical Center campus. Some of the activities that they have there, they're all, you know, fun and educational. So the idea is that the kids are having a good time,
right?
But both the children and their parents are taking away some important information. So the fire safety trailer is there every year, and that teaches kids and their parents how to, you know, kind of escape a home fire, kind of walks them through those steps.
Yikes, that does sound kind of fun in a way. So it's not a trailer like a movie trailer, it's a trailer.
Yeah, it's like a trailer, and they have some like smoke machines that do create smoke. It teaches them how, you know, how to get low and go.
Oh, wow.
You know, they escape through a window, and then they get to also practice making 911 phone calls so that, you know, in case they're ever in that situation, they know what to do.
Clever.
Yeah. And then we have, you know, Highway Patrol there, the police department will be there, firefighters. It's a really good opportunity for kids to get to interact with those professionals.
So they're not intimidated.
Yes, yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, because it can be scary for little kids sometimes. Sure. So to get to be with them in a fun environment kind of breaks down.
And that may help indeed. Yeah. You know, because if a child is subject to something that requires emergency personnel, we're talking trauma. There's some... You know, a lot of books on trauma say that if during a traumatic event you can recover yourself, normal heart rate, normal perception of the world, that goes a long way to preventing trauma.
Right.
So that, that, you know, if the event starts and closes on a even keel, it's a lot different than being frightened and then you're taken away or something.
Yeah, you think about, you know, in a home fire situation, firefighters are coming in all this big, bulky gear.
Yeah, right. The breathing like Darth Vader.
Yeah, and that itself can look scary. So just to kind of get them to interact with them up close, and they get to try on the fire suits too. So just makes it a little less scary.
And it may, is there that exercise, you know, I've seen some posters around that will say, you know, be safe, have a plan. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you'll see a PSA where... You know, the family gets together and say, oh, we're living in this multi-story house or whatever it is. Here's what where you ought to go out should you need to vacate the house.
Yes, we actually have some fire escape planning maps that families can take with them so that they can take it home and draw out their map for their house. And I mean, it's things like that. It's the planning, preparation, just being prepared.
Right.
You know, injuries from the situations that we're educating about the fair, which we call preventable injuries, so things like car crashes or home fires or poisoning, they're the leading cause of death for children in the United States. So this is really important that families know what steps they can take to protect their children.
And will there be something about car seats. Because sometimes we get really lost. Like they say, this must never face the front, or don't do this in the back, or, you know, what age should a child use a shoulder restraint?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we get a lot of questions like that. Safe Kids Worldwide is the certifying agency for car seat technicians throughout the country. So there are people that can help parents install their car seats. We will be promoting those checks at the fair. We won't have a car seat check there, but we will have information. National Seat Check Saturday is the week following, so we'll have a lot of information about parents.
But there is an opportunity.
Right. Yeah, that's good. Yeah. And, yeah,
as a brand new grandmother,
yes,
I have already a lot of car seat questions.
Exactly, right? You want to know, what are they doing with that little helpless
infant? Are we sure that's in there, Yeah,
yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. I mean, there's just every car seat's different. Every car is different.
Right.
When children move. So we'll have a lot of that information there for parents, as well as just the organized fitting stations that are in Missoula and when and how they can access those for help.
And this could be quite good for a new grandparent. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
You know, because first they're thrilled and then they're relied upon. So there comes that phase, you know, where grandparents sometimes, like it happened to my sister who has a, you know, I have a great nephew who's but 2 years old. Mm-hmm. But as the time has progressed, she's being called as a secondary caregiver more and more.
And it's been 28 years since I had an infant in my home, and things have changed, and best practices have changed. So as no matter how much you think you remember.
Well, and sometimes that just goes, you know, just is not top of your mind anymore because you haven't had a child
right.
at home for so long. So, you know, things that you knew you had done when you had children, like putting, you know, medications up and away, just isn't top of your mind because it hasn't been a concern.
Right.
So it's just a good reminder, which is why we do encourage parents, grandparents, caregivers, everyone to come out because I think everyone can learn something.
Yeah. I mean, now, it could be, I was just going to say that there are kids that want to be babysitters.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. Like, kids out there that
would be good for
15
them too.
Or 16 only, right? But I understand you get pretty good money now babysitting. Like, you know, honestly, like more than we could pay, you know. So anyway, if there are babysitting kids out there, you're
if
thinking
you
about
If you have some
it,
training, yeah.
Yeah, that would give you an edge over other babysitters if you take this
beat
training.
Beat the competition. I have a Joel question. The Joel question is, okay, so you say it's on the Community Medical Center campus.
Yes. Campus.
But like
campus
which is side? Large. That's huge.
It
yeah.
is large.
Where
so we'll
people
be
come in?
In the parking lot area and grassy area, kind of over by the Western Montana Clinic building. And you'll see us. We have a huge, big white tent set up.
Okay.
So we always have people just look for the tent on Fort Missoula Road.
On Fort Missoula Road, not
yes,
on
not
south.
On south.
Right.
Okay.
Well, that's important.
Key. Yeah.
Because everything's changed too at the park.
I know.
So.
Yes, I know.
And then my question is a Kim question, and that is pre-registration required?
No, not at all. This is just an open, free event for people
free
to come
event.
And stop
so
by.
So all this information
yes, everything
is free.
Is free. Lots of, you know, some of the activities I mentioned, but also just other, you know, service agencies in the community as well, so parents can connect with them. So, you know, it's fun, it's educational, but it's also an opportunity for parents and caregivers to connect with the services that are available to them in the community.
Yeah.
Great.
So it's really great.
And tooling around on, this is Saturday, correct?
It's a Sunday.
Sunday.
It's a Sunday. This
so when you're tooling
Sunday.
Around on Sunday or after church or wherever you're out
Sunday,
and about.
Sunday, September 23rd.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
so there's
weeks.
Time. Like this show will run
two
every day
weeks,
for 2 weeks.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And,
just drop by.
Yeah,
stay as long as you
wonderful.
Want.
Yep. And there's some other incentives. Mascot appearances, healthy snacks.
Healthy snacks.
Well, I'm getting you down the one, but giveaways and prizes.
And prizes.
So,
all
that's
right.
really great. Kira, thank you so much for doing
thank you
this
for having me.
Noble work.
Yes.
It really is. And thank you for taking the time to be here.
Yes, we appreciate the opportunity to talk about it. So.
You know it. And just when you think we'd run out of show, we've just barely gotten started.
Oh, yeah.
Here's a PSA, and we'll bring out our next guest right away.
Welcome to another edition of the Montana Department of Transportation's How to Drive a Roundabout. If a motorist is within a roundabout as an emergency vehicle is approaching, the motorist's actions should be identical to that as if within a traditional intersection. A driver should continue through the roundabout, leaving the intersection clear, and bear right if possible once through the roundabout. Nice, cowboy! Remember, do not stop in the roundabout or at the entrance of the configuration.
Oh no,
that's the wrong way. Following these instructions, you'll have no problem navigating the new roundabouts popping up all around Montana.
Oh, we're back.
There we go.
Well, and then we got a comment on that just for a second.
We love the roundabout ad.
Right. We think the roundabout ad is really,
I wish
really
someone
good.
Had asked me to do the car.
Yeah, yeah. And there's two large ones now with the Van Buren Street.
Oh, I know. And no one told me there were
Orange
two
Street.
In Van Buren.
Yeah.
Two boom boom.
I don't even know how they were, but I've heard there are two.
You can handle it. I just did it.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Okay. Yeah. Well, we are back, dear viewer. We are back with Michelle Johnson and Paula Strickland. They are representing VFW Post 209. Michelle, you are the auxiliary president. Paula, you are the auxiliary secretary. Welcome.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, you're most welcome. And so you were telling us this VFW Post is right next to Bigger Pizza on West Main Street.
That's correct.
I've known it forever because it's my way to walk home, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I've never really known more about it, so I'm so
right.
glad you guys came to tell us
oh,
more
yeah.
about it.
It's a fantastic thing. A lot of people think it's just a bar,
yeah.
but actually it stands for Veterans of Foreign Wars. Uh-huh. And not only is there a canteen side, but then there's the post side, and then we are kind of the sister to the post. So the way that we operate is we're the sister organization. It started out originally as the Ladies Auxiliary, mm-hmm. but we have expanded and now we take men and women. The only requirement is that you are related to a veteran who has served overseas in a combat zone. And if you're a grandparent, a mother, father, sister, brother, daughter, son, or grandchild, then you are eligible for our membership. As long as you're older than 16, and the dues are just $15.50. And we do a lot of great stuff. We have over 475 nationwide members. And then we have our local post. I think our membership is close to 100.
Wow.
So, and we're pretty new members, but yep. we're trying to recruit other people to join us because there's a lot of current conflict veterans out there, and we want to recruit their family.
I think most people maybe would have the same misconception that I have, which is that membership in an organization like this might be older than you guys are.
Mm-hmm. And it is.
But so it's great mm-hmm. to see two young women involved in this way.
Yeah.
And it makes us rethink, you know, the whole organization and who's there.
Right, and we need newer members because we don't want our organization to die out when those older veterans and their spouses
move on.
Moving on, exactly.
Well, and we know what you're talking about because Susan Campbell Renaud is no
yes.
stranger to this program.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
Yep.
Susan
Renaud's
amazing.
She's great.
When she is organizing like the Memorial Day mm-hmm. stuff, she's like, well, I'm still trying, you know, for the 21-gun salute. Sometimes it's a struggle,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
it seems like a huge undertaking without people to take up that message of appreciation,
right.
remembrance, and so on.
Yes.
You need some young blood.
What made you get involved?
My husband's a veteran, so he served in the Army for 8 years and went to Iraq twice, so he joined with Michelle's husband, and they're good friends, and then they drug us in. But
right.
yeah, I mean,
now they dragged you on television.
Yes.
What?
Yes. She drugged me on. But yeah, no, we do a whole lot of stuff, and Susan's been such a great mentor for all of us. We do the Memorial Day, Veterans Day breakfast that's open to the public. We also last year adopted 7 families, veteran families,
mm-hmm.
and we provided them with quite the spread of food, like a whole week's worth
great.
Of food
nice.
For them. And it was really interesting how we chose them because we really wanted to, you know, make it an impact for somebody.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So the way that we went about finding these families was we coordinated with the HUD-VASH, which is the Homeless Veteran Housing Program through the VA. And they found us veterans who not only had struggled with homelessness, but also had children in their home. So
wow.
we found mm-hmm. high-need families that we really cared to give them everything that we possibly could. And
sure.
we were able to
yeah.
Get a lot of local donations to provide that
yeah.
for them.
Because
so
anyone who's paying attention knows it's a crying shame
what's
going on with veterans in
yeah.
America.
Mm-hmm.
That they, if you're a veteran, you're 7 times more likely to be on the street
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
because of the trauma of war, et cetera,
right.
et cetera.
Right.
And thank goodness you guys are, you know, making a move to say, well, those people serve, now we're going to help.
Yep.
After the fact.
So everyone out there who sees you two on television right now and goes, oh, that could be really fun,
mm-hmm.
how do they get involved?
Well, we meet on the second Tuesday of every month at the Post at 245 West Main Street.
At get 7 a slice o'clock. Of pizza and then head right
yeah,
over
head
to
right
the Post.
In. We like to meet a few minutes. We bring food and chat beforehand, and we welcome anybody who wants to help. Even if you're not eligible for membership, there's other ways that you can help too. So that hopefully wouldn't stop anyone from coming down and saying hi to us on the second Tuesday of any month.
That's great.
Nice. Yeah. Well, do you have any other questions?
No, is tomorrow the second Tuesday?
It is.
Yeah.
September 11th.
Okay, my brain was
September
just...
September 11th to boot.
Yeah. Yeah.
September 11th to boot. I know Susan was on Scott's morning show talking about the...
that's
you
right.
know, the events that are going to be
That
held.
Would be an especially auspicious time to show up.
Yes. Yeah, so tomorrow at Rose Park at 7 is the memorial, and they're setting up over 4,000 flags for that.
Yeah. Wow. Mm-hmm.
So if you can't make it this Tuesday, come in October.
Yeah, okay. Right. Exactly. Yeah. Well, Michelle, Paula, thank you so much for taking the time.
Thanks.
And don't be a stranger. You can come back.
Let us know.
You know where we are, and there won't be as so much traffic, probably.
Right. Awesome. Okay. Sounds great.
All right. We'll be right back.
Oh, we're going to show a video about the
DFW. You guys made the 30-second video. Yep. Scott, can you do it?
That's a minute.
It's a minute.
He says I can do it.
Okay. So I think we're going to get to see them in action.
Yeah. And then you can collect your memory stick after.
Awesome. Thanks.
Thank you.
Intersections are where some of the most fatal crashes occur due to T-bone and head-on collisions. The Montana Department of Transportation is committed to building safe roadways throughout the state. Often, roundabouts are the solution to eliminating these types of crashes. Roundabouts reduce fatal collisions by 90%. And reduce collisions causing injury by 75%, according to the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. How do roundabouts reduce fatal and serious injury crashes? First, roundabouts naturally encourage drivers to slow for the intersection. Cars slow down to yield to other cars, which force cars when merging onto a roundabout to average 15 to 20 miles per hour. Lower speeds help limit impact if a crash does occur. Second, with no light to beat, drivers do not have the incentive to speed into the roundabout. Third, roundabouts move traffic through the intersection in one direction, thus essentially negating the possibility of T-bone or head-on crashes. This results in decreased traffic collisions, furthering Montana Department of Transportation's Vision Zero goal, ultimately eliminating deaths and injuries on Montana highways. So, as you see roundabouts appear around Montana, including a new set of roundabouts at the Van Buren Street interchange, you'll know roadways are becoming safer and more efficient. Taxpayers have tasked the Montana Department of Transportation with making Montana's roads safer. We take that mission seriously every single day.
Saturday Drop-Ins return for their third year of Stop Animation and Media Fun. Every Saturday from 1 to 5 p.m., your kid can work with Legos, play, and more to make their characters come to life. Animation isn't the only reason to stop in.
Hi!
Your kids can experience media through editing, voiceover, and short films. Games and activities to keep your kids busy all Saturday afternoon, starting September.
Oh, we're back. we are back with Cheryl Spotted Wolf and Erica Johnson. They're here to talk about Walk and Roll Week. Is it the 28th year? 27th year or something?
That sounds right.
Yeah, it sounds
sure,
right.
Sure, yeah.
Let me further introduce Cheryl and Erica by saying they are the bike ambassadors for the city of Missoula.
Yeah.
And you have seen an entire season of people using alternative transportation. So what do you think?
It's awesome. Missoula is awesome. I can't believe that I've lived in a community that is just embracing sustainable transportation, and it's just awesome to actually get on board and be a part of it.
Nice. Absolutely. I was out yesterday. I'm setting up my clip, you know, because I took some video of Sunday Streets for people. And Sunday Streets is it twice a year now or just once a year?
Just once a year.
Okay. And it's an opportunity for people to experience the main drag without vehicles. So Higgins Street was closed to vehicular traffic yesterday from about 4th Street going north to the Red Access. So Scott, can you roll the clip? He's gonna, and we can talk over it. You guys can see it, look, in that monitor.
Yeah.
So it has that business where it says one less car, take the pledge. And then here's the intersection of Broadway. And then here's some of the things that were going on, like a kid's gymnastics. I saw like parents and children trying out new bicycles. There was also printmaking that they were doing, like rolling stuff.
Yeah.
And they were doing guitar lessons.
That's so great. And all right in the middle of Higgins. Yeah. So this Sunday Streets and Bike-a-Palooza, which happened before.
We kicked it off.
Are the kickoff
right.
Events for
Walk and Roll Missoula.
Yes.
So this is in its 27th year. It says that, celebrate 27th year of Bike Walk Bus Week. But it changed its name and it changed its location. It used to be in spring and now the fall. Do you guys have a bunch of things to hand that's going on this week you want to talk about?
Yeah, well, Wednesday is probably like the big highlight. It's One Less Car Day, so we're asking as many people as possible to commit to being one less car on the road by using either carpool, transit, walking, or biking, skateboarding, whatever type of alternative transportation you can, and help reduce congestion, improve air quality, and just enjoy the community. Yeah.
You know, one thing I started saying on this day, especially about, like 5 years ago when we were talking about this exact same thing, is I think there are so many people in Missoula who have never been on a bus because they're just not sure what to do. And this is the day to just take that leap and hop on a bus. If you don't have to have change. It doesn't cost you anything.
It's free. I forgot about that.
You can go wherever you want to go. And
you could put a bike on it.
Yeah.
So you can kind of combo.
Exactly. Your so that is Wednesday the 12th would be if you've never been on that bus, just get on the bus.
Right.
And they have a really great app where you can see in real time where the bus is, so you don't have to worry about missing
it. Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah,
it's really phenomenal.
You just download it on a smartphone.
Yeah.
And it'll show you a picture of a little bus.
Oh, like the Uber thing. I tried that one time. I didn't do it right. And I was panicking because I had to get to the airport. So a brother-in-law did it for me. But I saw all these like things swarming around. Yeah. But this will show like, this is the bus I want.
And we'll show you the route. And where, and then you just push. There's some parts where it says you could do park and daily, or you know, just the street and a stop, and it'll tell you how many minutes you're at, or you can look at the street where you're at and just see how much longer, less than a minute,
three minutes. Missoula morning. Yeah. That could be really nice.
And speaking of morning, are you guys still doing coffee and treats?
Yes, the Breakfast Blitz will also be on Wednesday.
We've
got 10 locations lined up where we'll be offering coffee and breakfast treats to people who are using sustainable transportation.
Okay.
And that happens from 7:30 in the morning to 9:30 at 10 different locations here in the city.
Just go
to Missoula in Motion and take the pledge.
Missoula
and
in Motion.
And it'll show you those locations.
Right. Yeah.
Because look how many sponsors they've got.
Yeah, dozens of them.
Big Sky Bikes, El Cazador. These are the food places. Black Coffee Roasting, Clyde Coffee.
Yeah.
But I know a lot of places, Western Side.
Right.
Buttercup. That piggy place.
Notorious P.I.G.
Yeah, Notorious P.I.G.
So all those sponsors are offering special weekly deals to participants of Walk and Roll Missoula.
Yeah.
So pay attention. Go into your favorite coffee shop and look around. And if for some reason they're not already a sponsor, you know, it wouldn't hurt to just say,
well,
we're glad you guys are sponsoring this. That for next year, right?
There's two different things to Walk and Roll Week. When you do go and log on and you've done a sustainable transportation, even one trip, it gives you access to the daily deals, which is an e-coupon. Ooh. So the e-coupon's accessible on your smartphone or on your computer. You could print out the coupon or just show them on your smartphone.
Oh, that's so
hey, I've got
smart.
$5 off at Liquid Planet.
Oh, it's and time then, to cash in for being a good
yeah.
Yeah. And then on the rest of it is if you, as long as you take the pledge or you're participating in this, you're also eligible for up to 30 more different raffles that they're doing throughout the week. So there's more than just the daily deals.
Wow.
There's raffles that they're giving away, a ton of stuff that is just trying to encourage you and help you feel good about the fact that you bike, bus, or walk that week.
And and to do that, people go to MissoulaEmotion.com mm-hmm. and they'll see the enrollment.
Yeah.
Is it .com or .com?
It is .com, okay. Which is, you know, you think it would be
I know
org,
I'm in the nonprofit
whatever,
world,
but they make it .com.
There's so many more things going on this week, but we've got to move on.
Yes.
So go to MissoulaEmotion.com and yes. you'll get the whole yes. schedule of
yeah.
events.
Yeah.
Plus and coupons and cool stuff.
Yeah, and as I always try to point out to the dear viewer, it doesn't mean you're a bad person because you rely on your car.
True.
No.
It's not like it's holier than thou week.
Nope. No.
It is like, it's just like try it out week.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
all it is.
Exactly.
It's like you might discover something else. You know, people have said, well, I never knew how cool the buses were. Like I went on when we brought kids last summer to KUFM and I was like, whoa, the lighting is amazing on this. It has free Wi-Fi and the whole
free
thing
Wi-Fi.
Is free.
Yeah,
free Wi-Fi.
Also,
free.
There's some pleasures to walking home from work because by the time you get home, you can kind of decompress. So there's that.
I used to always moan and groan about there's no parking at Farmer's Market. And then one day I went, you could walk to Farmer's Market and then you wouldn't have to worry about parking.
Right.
So there you go. Okay.
Well, we better go. Cheryl, Erica, thank you so much for being bike ambassadors this season.
Thank you
and
for
participating
us.
In the Out and About.
Yeah.
That's on Facebook and YouTube if you guys haven't seen it.
Oh, great.
Okay.
Good.
All right. We better go because we have two more guests
thank
before
you so much.
We turn into pumpkins here.
Okay.
So we'll be right back after this.
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable. With you that time you felt most alone. And with you when you realized you would never be. They were with you when you shared your love with the world. And with you when she became your world. Your girls have never left you. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them?
You don't know mine.
Knowing your breasts can save your life.
Elder abuse is a growing problem, and it's happening right here in our Montana communities. At least 1 in 10 older adults are victims of physical or emotional abuse, financial exploitation, or neglect. To get help or report elder abuse, call your local area agency on aging or Adult Protective Services at 1-844-277-9300.
So how was work?
It was 1,300 hours. My math class from 302 was in the trenches. Davy Roth had it the worst. Fractions were coming at him left and right. He just didn't get the damn things. 2 days ago, I tried to teach him what 1/4 of 1/2 was using different sizes of blocks. Yesterday, I tried again by dividing up pizza. Both missions failed.
Oh, no.
But today, I was ready. I created a combat math game where the only way to beat the enemy is to out-fraction them. Davey conquered every last denominator.
Yeah, wireless. Oh, we're back.
Here we are.
I was going to complain, dear viewer, and say most of my wireless microphones broke over the summer.
That's no.
What, yes. We are here with Barb Thoreau. She is representing this time the Book Festival, and yay, it is coming up, isn't it?
It's coming. The dates are September 27th through the 30th, so yeah, Thursday through Sunday.
Wonderful.
And some full days, yeah, which will be great.
Yeah. An event very, very dear and near to my heart.
I know.
Yeah, well. I'm yes, so glad to be talking to someone else about
it. Like, oh, Kim and I talked a lot about book festivals over the years.
But it's evolved and changed and it's vibrant and exciting. And tell us some of the best events that are going on.
Well, there's going to be 60 events this year at 14 venues, okay, which are downtown as well as at the Fort Missoula, where there's an evening event out there.
Neat.
And I think we're up to 150 presenters this year.
Wow.
And I just brought this in to show Kim. The schedule went live.
The schedule's
alive.
That's always a huge landmark.
And it's available at the website, which is montanabookfestival.org.
Right.
So you can go there. And it's a live working schedule. So keep looking for bios and different things.
Scott's showing it to people at home. And
yeah,
really.
Well, I mean, one of the best things about having an online schedule is you can keep adding to it.
Absolutely.
As information comes in. And so don't just look at it once and print it out and think, mm-hmm, that's it.
And Kim knows that because we're having a placeholder for some events that the Montana Center for the Book is doing.
For instance, yes. There'll be new information tomorrow from the Center for the Book.
Center of the Book is doing some things on Saturday. The Missoula Writing Collaborative has I love their gummy bear and goldfish reading that they do from their summer workshop.
That's
on Friday. The big event is at the Wilma on Saturday, the 29th at 7 o'clock, which is a publication release reading and celebration for a new collection called Hearth, which is co-edited by Susan O'Connor and Onyx Smith of Missoula.
Oh,
and
nice.
It's a collection of writers that are talking about what hearth means.
Mm-hmm.
There's poetries, there are essays, there are some wonderful, there's one photographer that has contributed some information too. So Onyx and Susan, Deborah Magpie Erling, Gretel Ehrlich, Charles Merrill, and I know there's one name I'm forgetting, but you can go find that out on that
schedule.
On the Groovy website, showing the pictures of the festival, too.
From the past, yeah.
Yes.
Now, I had someone ask me this morning, as a matter of fact, are there ticketed events, or are most events free?
There are no ticketed events this year. There will be festival buttons. I know they're going to be selling those for $15. I was asking, when will they be available? I think within the next week they'll be pre-sold, but they will be on sale at all of the venue sites.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't think you're going to go to more than one event, then you can pay $5 and just get in at one time. But
mm-hmm,
it's a bargain for $15.
Oh,
and it'll have artwork from our new poster, which is again done by Max Mon. And it features a cat and a book and an ashtray and a bottle of something to drink.
That's it.
It's perfect.
It screams writer to me.
Yeah. Well, this event is now going, what, into its 17th year? Did you do it for
19 years.
And,
yeah,
people like it and support it. I think something that we're excited about again this year is the Public House is going to be a facility both on Friday and Saturday. And all things poetry will be at the Public House.
That's great. So people will know, just go there. Something good poetry-wise will be going on.
If you want to know where the poetry events are, and there'll be panels and readings, and both days will start with something called Start the Day with Poetry. And there'll be four different poets that'll be reading.
Cool.
And a lot of different environmental writers. Rick Bass is going to be leading something on saving the grizzly. So that gets into environmental writer becoming politically involved, and he's very much involved with saving the grizzlies and stopping a grizzly hunt and things like that.
So. Yeah. We better go because he's indicating we're running out of time. We have.
Can someone come back in 2 weeks and tell us more? You'll have even more information. Yeah.
We will be able to do that.
Okay.
But the good news is the schedule's live.
The schedule's live. So go to montanabookfestival.org.
Great. We'll be back with Jack Shiflett of NAMI right after this incredibly brief message.
5 minutes.
I'm Attorney General Tim Fox. Nowadays, all of you have to worry about cybersecurity. Something as simple as visiting pirate websites can put your computer at risk. Hackers use pirate websites to infect your computer and steal your ID and financial information, or even take over your computer camera without you knowing it. Don't let hackers into your house. Be careful with the websites you visit and warn your kids on how to stay safe online. To learn more, visit my website.
And ask, I guess.
We are back because we were running out of time. Sorry,
oh my gosh.
We clipped that one. Jack Shiflett is here from NAMI, Missoula. Welcome and thank you for all the time you've been so patient. So, Suicide Prevention Week is coming up. NAMI is the National Alliance for the Mentally Ill, and the Missoula chapter, you are a member, and take it from there.
I am not just a member, I'm actually the president of NAMI Missoula. And yes, the National Alliance on Mental Illness. And, you know, we've been operating here in Missoula for, I guess, about 30 years, a little over 30 years. And what we do, I'll get to our events, but just so that folks know what we do, we provide support, we provide education, we provide advocacy for individuals who live with mental illness and also for their families, their friends, their loved ones. So we have education programs and support groups. We have a lot of resources at our office that are available for folks to use. And again, we try to serve as kind of a an advocate for people who are struggling to deal with the illness, but also with the mental health system, which is somewhat complicated.
Right.
So we're there for them for that. So this is Suicide Prevention Week, not just here in Missoula, but this is a nationwide Suicide Prevention and Awareness Week. And it's mainly sponsored nationwide by the American Foundation on Suicide Prevention. Here in Missoula, there's a group called Project Tomorrow that used to be the Missoula Suicide Prevention Network, but it's now called Project Tomorrow. And that includes folks from, for instance, Peter Snyder from the Providence Center. They've gotten very, very involved in Suicide Prevention Week. It includes the United Way. It includes the Missoula City County Health Department. So all kinds of groups are involved in this. And NAMI Missoula is very pleased to be part of this week's activities. I don't have the entire schedule for the Suicide Prevention Week, and I didn't know if you had somebody from Project Tomorrow perhaps coming in to talk about it, but I can tell you we have two events coming up. And so our first one that we are co-sponsoring with Project Tomorrow is this Thursday, which is September 13th. It starts at 6:30 Thursday evening at the Public House, which is 130 East Broadway. And this is called Out of the Darkness, Voices of Hope. Out of the Darkness is kind of the brand name that American Society for Suicide Prevention has put onto. They do an annual walk, and that walk is coming up here in Missoula this Saturday, the 15th of September. But there's other events going on leading up to that, and we wanted to do this. There are events that include the visual arts that Project Tomorrow has scheduled for this week, and there's going to be music at the Public House on Friday evening. There's going to be a band there doing songs of hope. So I'm a writer, and some of my friends through NAMI Missoula are writers as well, and we wanted to get the spoken word involved in this as well. So, you know, music, visual arts, walking on Saturday, but we'll do some talking Thursday night. And so the idea is to get as many people in the community together. I mean, I've invited some of my friends who are writers, and they've contacted some of their writer friends. But this is not a formal literary event. What this is going to be, Voices of Hope on Thursday evening, is going to be kind of an open mic sort of arrangement, and I'll be the MC, and basically anybody who shows up and would like to get up and either read a short poem or a short piece of prose that they find inspirational and hopeful, that has been helpful to them in dealing with their darkness that they've encountered for whatever reason, and not just suicide, because we understand that people go through all kinds of darkness in their lives, and so it isn't limited to folks who have lost someone to suicide. It's about where is that light of hope, and what is the sound of hope to you? And so we'll be doing that Thursday evening. It's free. And again, nobody needs to sign up in advance. Anybody who wants to read, we'll try to fit them all in. I'll be in charge of yanking people off the stage if they've taken. I've done it before, so
it's
I can.
It's always part of it. Yeah.
Yeah. So that is going on Thursday, and that is co-sponsored by Project Tomorrow, and they have been great to work with. And the folks at the Public House, who I had not worked with before, they've just been great in making the space available.
That's a great new resource in town.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. And they're going to do all the setup and cleanup. So all I have to do is show up and talk. So
that's
really easy.
I can do that.
Yeah. So that's this week. The other event that we've got coming up, and this is just a NAMI Missoula. This will not be a Project Tomorrow event. But we are having our third annual benefit event on Friday, September 21st. Cool. It will be at the Imagination Brewing Company, where we've had it the last 2 years. It goes from 5 o'clock until 8 o'clock that evening. It's called Beautiful Minds. And we present it as a benefit event, but you know, there's no cover charge. It's a free event. We'll have music. We've got local musicians. Mark Chase, Chris Pumphrey, and Robin Shepherd are performing, and they may bring some friends along, and so there may be some surprise guests. We really think of it, I mean, it's a benefit, but it's a celebration. It's a celebration for us at NAMI Missoula. It's also a celebration of how supportive this community is. This is just an incredible community, supporting not just NAMI, but you folks know better than I do probably the number of groups, nonprofit and otherwise. And so we want to celebrate all of them. Yeah. And the folks at Imagination who are so generous.
Exactly, they're a great example.
Yeah. So we want to celebrate them as well.
And that's Friday the 21st?
That is Friday the 21st from 5 o'clock to 8 o'clock at Imagination Brewing. And I should mention that NAMI Missoula, we don't get any money from the sale of alcohol. We've been clear about that.
Yeah.
A brewery, a place like Imagination Brewing Company, it's actually a very family-friendly venue, and a lot of people don't recognize that. But still, given the link between mental health issues and alcohol and so forth, we're careful to point out that we're not making any money from the sale of alcohol. People want to donate, that's fine. We'll have our donation jars.
See,
or if people just want to come and listen to music and have fun, we'll be there to answer questions. Folks from NAMI Missoula will be there. We try not to give a big sales pitch or spiel. People are there to have fun and to hear the music. And so we're there to answer questions more than anything else. So that's what we've got coming up. I should also mention, if I have time real quickly,
we are
co-sponsoring an event as part of the Montana Book Festival. And I don't know if Barbara Thoreau just mentioned that.
No, we gave her the bum's rush. So
okay, I noticed she got out of here pretty quickly. But we are co-sponsoring an event that's going to take place on Saturday, the 29th of September, as part of the Book Festival. It'll be that afternoon from 3 to 4 o'clock at the Montgomery Distillery.
Oh, great.
And I don't want to give the wrong impression that all our events are taking places at alcohol-related venues, but we were approached, actually, to see if we would help sponsor an author by the name of Ellen Forney, who is coming in from Seattle. She is a cartoonist who has published a couple of books about her struggle and her experience with bipolar disorder. So we were contacted by folks at the book festival who asked if we would help bring her in, which we are happy to do. And Zan Bacchus, who is a local poet and a member of NAMI, is going to be reading poetry as kind of the introduction to Ellen's performance that day. So that's 3 to 4 o'clock on September the 29th
that
at the Montgomery Distillery.
That sounds like a great event. And what a great idea to bring in as many partners as possible, like NAMI, to add to the wealth of the book festival.
Well, and we were happy to be invited, to be honest. It's not something probably we would have thought of on our own, but given that the author that's coming in, her books are about mental health issues.
Very appropriate.
And so it makes perfect sense.
Thanks for everything you are doing. My gosh.
Thank you.
Now, is there a website people can go to take a look at all the different things
Absolutely.
Going on?
We are at www.namimissoula.org, and we also have a Facebook page, so that's just, you know, go on to Facebook and then NAMI Missoula.
And
we have an event, we have event pages for both of these events. I have finally learned that that's a good idea to do.
I'm a slow adapter,
but I eventually got there. So we have event pages, and and our phone number is 880-1013. If people have questions about these events or any of our programs, anything that we do, they should feel free to call.
Excellent, Jack. Thank you.
Thank you both so much.
You're most welcome. And thank you, dear viewer, for watching this first premiere of
season. We're back.
For MCAT, I'm Joel Baird.
And I'm Kim Anderson.
We'll see you next time.
Bye.